Domain expansion. Wouldn't it be cool if you could do this in real life? Ever since watching Jujutsu Kaisen, I've been fascinated by the way characters use hand signs to unleash their powers. Seeing them doing this makes me want to be able to do it myself. And this took me back to my Naruto days. You know, those cool ninjutsu hand signs that we all used to do? The creating shadow clones or forming a powerful Rasengan. Or maybe that's just me. But my obsession with anime hand signs never went away. And that's why, as I was watching Jujutsu Kaisen, I kept thinking, how can I use hand signs to change environments just like the anime? And after some research, I came across a crazy idea. So crazy that I don't even know if it's possible. But anyways, here's the idea. What if I train a machine to recognize the different domain expansion hand signs? Then each hand sign would then change the environments behind me to that specific domain using something like a projector. Okay, first, to make sure this was actually doable, I tested to see if I can train a machine based on my hands using a free software called Wekinator. For the domain expansion hand signs, I decided on using these four. I then unleashed my domains onto the webcam, trying to get the computer to identify each gestures as 1, 2, 3, or 4. If you're like me, you probably think that training a machine is super complicated, but it doesn't always have to be that way. Let me show you. First, select the number for the hand sign, then press record. Press stop, repeat for each hand sign. Press train, and that's it. But getting the machine to categorize my hand was just the beginning. Next, we need to use this awesome visual programming tool called HandPoseOSC, which can do cool things like these. But all we're using this for is to send the numbers to play the correct animation. But that was actually too hard, so I'll first try to get the numbers to pick the right colors. And that's also too hard because I don't know how to use HandPoseOSC. So first, I followed along with a bunch of YouTube tutorials to learn the basics. And once I was more confident, I started building the system. I've actually been wanting to learn HandPoseOSC for a while, so this project was essentially an excuse for me to try it out. But needless to say, this was much harder than I expected. I have no idea if any of this was actually going to work, and I was starting to question whether I was just wasting hours and hours of effort. So when I got this to work for the first time, as you can see, I was pretty happy. It wasn't working that well yet, but this was a huge boost in my confidence. And for the first time, I felt like this silly idea was actually doable. So with this newfound motivation, I doubled my efforts, trying my best to get this to play the right animation. And watching me refine is pretty boring, so I'll just skip ahead. Oh, too far. Okay, back a little. Okay, back to the first working prototype. I won't go into details, but basically this part receives a number. This part uses the number to pick the right video. And this part plays the video. So you might be wondering, what does this actually look like? Well, a little something like this. There was still a lot to fix, like the weird delays and flickers between each video, but I was overjoyed to see this actually working. Because with this, I'm pretty much done. All that's left was to connect this to a projector, which was easier said than done. As usual, new issues are showing up. Things like hands not being recognized in the dark, and the flashing animation causing the program to lose track of my hand. But can we first talk about how cool this looks with the projector? I mean, can you believe this? I know it's just a projection, but I'm controlling it. Actually, the idea of using projection for domain expansion was so silly and simple that I didn't have much expectation, so I was stunned to see this. With each fix, I feel one step closer to bringing anime powers to life. And once everything was ready, I went to a nice dark room, set up the projector, test the system, And then here's the final results. Okay, maybe a little more adjustments, and...
Oh!
In Jujutsu Kaisen, the main expansion is used against an opponent, so I invited some friends over to show them the true power of Jujutsu sorcery.
Okay,
And with this, my childhood dreams of using anime hand signs came true. I was really happy to see how this turned out, not to mention how much I learned about creating interactive art. But now, I find myself asking, what's next? What else can I do with these tools? Can we turn illustrations into unique art experiences? Or what other fun, silly things can we do? Oh, one last thing. Other than using hand signs, you can also use other inputs, like voice, to do something like summon the Divine General Mahoraga.
Furube, yura yura.
Furube, yura yura. Yatsuka no surugi. Ikai shinsho. Bakura. Oh my god, it works.